Oh, hang on, that's me. Handy that. I can introduce myself. What can I say about myself? Well, I'm Mick. I used to be on telly. Not so much anymore. Apparently, I'm too old to be young. And too young to be old. So, that's annoying. Also, because you may know that television's all about new talent nowadays. Apparently, I'm old talent. That's great. I can live with that. I don't mind. That's young lie. It drives me up the wall. I want to be young people getting on television making spit. Moving on in a cheerful manner. Why am I here tonight? Well, I became a wheelchair user at the age of 15, and it's a bit of a shock when you wake up to go to your German O level and discover that you can't walk anymore. Annoyingly, my school sent my teacher, Miss Fleckney, to my bedside in my hospital bed. And so I did my German O-level while everyone thought I might be dying. Now, it was very useful, I thought, just what I need to know that I've got a German O-level. Hello there, can I come and tell you? Tag? Yes. Luckily, of course, I didn't die, hurrah! But I was left in a wheelie type situation. And it's quite a shock. You know, one minute you're there, being cold, useless at rugby. The next minute, they haven't invented wheelchair rugby yet, so you're kind of safe. It meant that I didn't really have any friends, because friends go away. 15's the age when they go anyway. But they really go when you suddenly come out of hospital and can't, you know, hang out in pubs anymore. Not that we hung out in pubs before, because we were far too young. Anyway, so I used to go to the local Phab club, and I made lots of friends. But I also realised that I could rebuild my life, and Phab was the jumping board that allowed me to rebuild my life and become the overly confident, mouthy git you see before me today. And I know lots of disabled people who say the same thing. My good friend Baroness Jane Campbell still has really close friends that she made at Phab when she was a little girl. And I think that we tend to forget that we always talk about what it does for disabled people, but it also does a lot for non-disabled kids. They turn up, they meet us, disabled types. That's good, because I don't want to worry about anything. But as I found out when I was 15, disability can happen to any of us. And if you normalise it, it's no big deal. You wake up one morning, you can't walk. I've got a great wheelchair. Next thing you know, you're playing wheelchair basketball. You're on the Paralympics. You get a job on television. My job on television. And I can't get it because I'm far too unhealthy to be a Paralympian. And with that, I shall never say that's enough about me.